Everybody, welcome to the Mean Boys Podcast. You either die an obscure cult hero or live long enough to do an ill-advised reunion show. I'm Keith Carey.
I'm Connor McSpadden.
I'm Tom Goss.
And we're back, bitch.
We're back.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're back. We exist once more.
We have returned from the void to the realm of form to wreak havoc upon your ears.
Yeah. Fucking happy 9/11, everyone. Yeah. This is the gift you deserve.
Oh, God, we are too good to our fans bringing the show back on 9/11.
It couldn't have timed out better. Like, to the point where, like, we've been talking about this for a little bit, and I was like, we could go right now, like, on September 1st, and I'm like, or.
Well, the thing was, the date that made perfect sense happened to be 9/11.
Yeah.
Like, when we looked at all the variables, it was the most prudent business maneuver to do it on 9/11.
It's like God wanted this to happen. Sorry, Tom.
Oh, no. All the most special, like, Mean Boys things happen on 9/11. The Steve Renazzisi episode. The other Steve Renazzisi episode. All those New Yorkers dying. All the most important things in our hearts have happened on 9/11.
Well, now something good has happened on 9/11. You know, we have reason to celebrate.
Yeah. The best thing that happened on 9/11 is you remember you forgot to delete this show from your feed when we canceled it the first time.
Yeah.
By the way, I should get in front. You mentioned it. A lot of people are probably waiting for the big Steve Renazzisi reveal. Steve couldn't be here. He did send me a letter, though.
It's weird. Interesting.
Yeah, he snail mailed this to me.
He's a big letter writer.
This is from Steve Renazzisi and is definitely 100% real. Dear Mean Boys, hey, it's me, Steve Renazzisi. You remember, I was the guy on the league with the hair. So sorry I couldn't be there for the 9/11 show, but I'm very busy fighting on the front lines here in Ukraine. Boy, oh boy, are my dogs barking from a long day of dodging machine gun fire and saving orphans. I know you might think I'm making this up, but it's super true. There's pictures online. Just Google Brave Soldier Ukraine, and the first guy you see with his back to the camera, that's me. Sincerely, Steve Renazzisi, via my assistant, my girlfriend who lives in Canada, and the internet works different there, so that's why I can't post any pictures of us. You know, so that was nice of Steve to reach out.
His forehead is actually kind of shaped like Ukraine, so that makes a lot of sense.
Vladimir Putin is fucking annexing his eyebrows.
We have done more to keep the Steve Renazzisi 9/11 story alive than the people who tried to cancel him in the first place. At this point, like, we're actively against.
It's like, it is the one rumor we've dug in on and been like, no, this is our pet cause.
Well, I mean, people would have forgotten about it if we didn't throw it a fucking parade every year.
Oh, I have to remind people what happened. Most people don't know what happened. They don't know that they said that. They really don't know. The kids don't know Steve Renazzisi.
They also don't know us.
I meet young cats at open mics, and they don't understand how funny it is that this guy was on our show in 9/11, and that's sad to me.
I'm just going to imagine Tom yelling this at just strangers on a bus somewhere.
This is like the weirdest sign of getting older. It's like, man, I remember when people used to hate Steve Renazzisi. Actually, things were so much more simpler in the mid-Obama years.
Yeah.
Actually, honestly, the oldest I've felt is I was at a bar, I was drinking, I was talking to this girl, and the girl just randomly, like, we were talking about some other shit. She goes, wait, what was 9/11 like? And I was like, what? And she was like, do you remember 9/11? I was like, well, yeah. And she was like, what was it like? I was like, oh, my God, that's... People are 21 and drinking, and they weren't alive for 9/11. I felt fucking ancient when she asked me that.
Yeah, that's just those just came out, legal drinking, no 9/11 people.
Oh, yeah. No, they
were made in 2001, 2002.
Yep, it's a bummer. Sorry, I got to fix something. This is sinking. Yeah. Oh, this isn't a bit.
Doing the same thing for me. We are in, for the listening, we've built a sort of punji pit of mic stands here. You're not going to believe this, but we weighted them weird. I'm just going to hold mine like this.
Okay, that works.
I lied. There's no fucking way I'm going to do that. I do not have the upper body strength. I don't want to see how low this gets to where I have to do the rest of the podcast laying down.
I was about to make a fat joke about you not being able to hold that microphone, and you were so fat, you fucking were fat before I could make a joke about it.
Keith, pretend it's ice cream.
I'm fatter than the speed of sound.
Yes.
I'm the Chuck Yeager of big ass sandwiches.
Well, now I get to a front row seat for Tom Goss, microphone mechanic.
Yeah. No, I keep forgetting which way's tight.
We were setting up the mic stands, and like me and you, Connor, were having like sort of a hard time getting the balance right, and Tom nailed his on one. And I was like, oh, did we fuck up the chemistry of this show? Where Tom actually nailed it.
Oh, now it's completely flaccid. That's good.
What is happening?
It's righty tighty, lefty loosey.
This is our big reunion.
Yeah. Just listen to Tom screw a microphone. This is what you've been fucking clamoring for in my DMs for 4 years, Mean Boys listeners.
We're dumber than theoretical Pollocks. Like,
at least they eventually get to a hockey game or buy a light bulb.
Yeah. The squeak of that bolt, Tom, is one of my favorite things in the world.
Well, I keep fucking up which way because the little knot
changed. Stays the same way, though. Okay, how are we doing?
Okay, almost there. I'm just going to make it really tight. For the listening audience, this is my first joke. screwing it in.
You know what?
I nailed it.
Should we get into our first segment, boys?
No, we should awkwardly hem and haw with mic stands for another 40 minutes.
I can take it away.
All right. Fellas, it's time for the Mexican joke off.
Ay, so topical.
All right. A Santa Monica woman woke up to see a naked man in her bedroom. Upon confronting him, the man yelled, "Oh my God, I'm so sorry, wrong house. I was trying to rape someone else."
Yeah, I don't know. The app told me to go here. Yeah. Our post rapes.
Uber meets.
Yeah. Oof. Yeah, I don't know. It's 2 a.m. Sometimes you just want some Taco Bell and a lifetime of dark memories.
Casual Encounters needs an app.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. They need to accelerate that environment.
Right.
All right, guys. Jimmy Buffett has passed away at 76. Tom Goss posted on social media, RIP Bruce Springsteen.
I literally spent 2 hours trying to write a version of this joke, and I was like, Connor's going to get it.
That was a callback to my favorite Meme Boys moment of all time when we got into a 10-minute fight about how much Jimmy Buffett sucks or Bruce Springsteen sucks before Tom realized he was talking about Jimmy Buffett.
Yeah. No, and I didn't really know Bruce Springsteen, and you know what? You guys are right. I've gotten really into him. And you were right about him being many stories about my life, and we'll get to that later in the show.
We'll be dissecting the album Nebraska and how it's actually just a series of tableaus from Tom's childhood.
Here's the thing, Tom, you're an aging white man, so you can really like track your progress in terms of how much you appreciate Bruce Springsteen.
Oh, is that
it's like the rings of a tree for elderly honkies. You
okay.
Know what I mean?
Yeah. Once you start to like the album The River, you're officially 60.
Oh yeah, that's when you become a Republican. all right, I'll do this one. Scientists say they've created a multimedia tool that allows them to detect autism in users. In a related story, if you were really excited when you saw Meme Boys was back, I have some even bigger news for you.
All right.
My phone just catches on fire.
I'll do this one. Lead singer of Smash Mouth, Steve Harwell, died. He will be buried with the shape of an L on his forehead. Fucking loser.
Well, the ground starts coming and it doesn't stop coming. Damn, that is really sad. I didn't realize this happened until a little after, but that's really brutal. As a huge Smash Mouth fan, I'm never going to see them at the Great Man Live.
No, he better have a 21 T-shirt cannon salute with Shrek memorabilia shot out of it.
But you know, it, they're doing the funeral, and that's going to be sad. But at the after party, they're making waffles. Dude, fucking Smash Mouth guy and Jimmy Buffett in 1 week is like all of our lazy punchline characters are dying now.
I know. Someone needs to keep an eye out on Nickelback because
put Guy Fieri in that bunker where the president goes before the nukes.
Like. Yeah.
Oh man, the internet's gonna be a really mean place when Nickelback dies.
I like that we're referring to Nickelback as one organism.
It is one organism.
Like they're definitely gonna die at the same time.
They're a hive mind of aliens. Okay.
Well, I feel like
vampires.
Stop spreading this rumor that they're human beings. They aren't.
But on a practical level, if you're in Nickelback, who can you hang out with besides other people that are in Nickelback? Who else really gets it?
The guys from Trapped. The guys from not Smash Mouth anymore.
The guys from Stained. The guys from Creed.
Yeah.
Every time somebody hilarious dies, they just come back as a ghost band member of Nickelback.
Yeah, Nickelback has been dead for 400 years. They just keep returning. You plant a boogie board in a garden and water it with Monster Energy drink, and Chad Kroeger grows from the ground to sing about photographs again.
Now,
and Tom does an accent from a country that doesn't exist.
We're back, baby.
That was somewhere between like Obi-Wan Kenobi and the guy who used to announce SNL. Like,
I do like that it's part of Steve Harwell's funeral rites that he has an ashen L on his forehead when he dies.
Yeah, no, I enjoyed it too.
His river Styx that he crosses is just full of fucking Red Bull and Jägermeister.
It's the river mozzarella Styx.
There it is.
Honestly, that guy was probably a lot of fun to hang out with.
I mean, Steve Harwell?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I remember being in middle school watching him play the, or it might have been elementary school, playing the NHL All-Star game.
Oh, and yeah. What song did they play?
Oh. Might as well be Walking on the Sun.
We're going deep cuts. Yeah.
They do the All-Star game. They don't play All-Star.
Right. How did none of us think of that?
Yeah.
Everyone played. Then the Morning Comes, the B-side from...
But all of Fushume.
We're all doing Bare Naked Ladies covers tonight.
And we're just going to see if anybody notices.
Oh, wait. Was it them and the Bare Naked Ladies? Or am I thinking of the Bare Naked Ladies?
I wasn't there.
Bare Naked Ladies. No, it was both of them.
My roommate just told me that you and her once time listened to the Bare Naked Ladies for like an entire drive, the same song.
We did, yeah, yeah. I like the Bare Naked Ladies.
Kiss Me?
Pinch Me.
Pinch Me, that's right, yeah. It's a satisfying song.
It's a nice, easy, like, it's what when you don't want to think, but you want to feel something, but you don't know what you want to feel, you listen to Pinch Me.
Well, and if you love rap music, but you hate black people.
That was the appeal of Bare Naked Ladies. Like, Canadians can rap too.
Uh-huh. Well. And then you listen, you're like, kinda?
Yeah.
All right, boys. A woman smuggled a gun into a White Sox game in her belly fat, which begs the question, what was a Raiders fan doing at a White Sox game? Thank you.
I do like the idea of like her having to rummage around in her stomach fat for a minute.
Nope, somewhere in here. Nope, Junior Mints. Nope.
Like it's Mary
lipstick.
Poppins' bag. She pulled like a full umbrella.
Yeah. She's got like cartoon space in there.
The guy who has to get shot is just waiting patiently. Well, she's like, oh, this seems like it's going to be bad. I should move. All right. Sorry, my mic is syncing again. A group of Texas prisoners started a Dungeons & Dragons group. This marks the first time that a bunch of guys found a way to simultaneously be rapists and virgins.
That's fun. All right. Oh, man, we're having to do so much kung-fu-ery with the mic.
We got it. We'll figure it out.
A spotless giraffe was born in a Tennessee zoo. Damn, that sounds like a really clean giraffe.
Shut the fuck up.
Fuck you. I like the idea that Tennessee is racist enough. They're like, get the black off that giraffe. Yeah.
All these, you know, dirty giraffe stereotypes only exist because of white people.
Yeah, look, we're trying to be more woke. Can we call them giraffe African American police?
Yeah, no, technically that story is about a African getting blacker in America, if you really think about it. All the whites, okay.
Wait, what color do you think a giraffe is?
It's brown.
With black spots.
So but the actual giraffe was just brown.
Okay.
I think of him as kind of yellow with brown spots.
I kind of think of like as an orangish yellow. I guess I'm just thinking of the logo from Toys R Us.
Yeah.
Which is not like scientifically accurate.
I seen a real life giraffe or two.
I've seen the giraffe.
In my livings.
Yeah, no, the giraffe, if you haven't seen it, it's a brown giraffe.
If you haven't seen it, if you're unfamiliar.
It's really cute. It's a cute giraffe. I love animals.
It's spotless.
Tom doing a news report on just basic things. They're calling them giraffes. They might look like horses, but they're actually quite long.
Circles. There's not a side on these things.
Yeah, no, it's a very cute baby. No spots, all brown, and it looks weird. It looks like if an anteater became a giraffe is kind of what it looks like.
All right, I got to check this guy out.
Yeah, no.
I have an animal story. 5 million bees escaped a truck after a crash in Canada. They caught them by releasing 5 million Asian parents asking, why not A?
Not one of those bees grew up to be a doctor. They were furious.
Pieces of shit.
I also have an animal story. Gettysburg has opened a feline-themed Civil War museum. So, man, if you thought it was unlucky to be a black cat before. Slavery.
All right. Kim Jong-un and Putin are going to be meeting to discuss weapons. This meeting is a casual, but the by the third one, Putin is hoping to thrust his missile in Kim's silo.
We don't, gay sex.
Yeah, we don't. We don't have to laugh at that one. It was a miss. That's okay.
They're calling him Gay Joe. Normally, penises go into vaginas, but now we're shaking it up. More at 11.
The year is 2003. Well, let's see if this esoteric nonsense buys me some credibility. Austria will give a free year of public transportation to anyone who gets a tattoo of their new climate ticket program. Because nothing bad ever happened after a free tattoo and a train ride in Austria.
The last guy from Austria who did this plan only paid for the one-way ticket, though.
Yeah.
So, you know, this is a little bit... it's so many bad decisions at once. You're like, they had to have done it on purpose.
Yeah, like, they must have known ironic fucks like me were going to go call them out on it and raise awareness for their climate ticket program. Well,
what I love about this is that also means just inherently based on culture, that means their program is also no Jews allowed because Jews can't get tattoos.
Oh, they can't get tattoos.
So the one deal they couldn't get in Austria, they don't get to get.
Damn, and they love savings.
Yeah.
Dude, that's why we call them Technicality Tom. That is a fucking that is a brutal technicality. That is the Jew-proofed jump.
Yeah.
I do love the idea of somebody like, do I want to be buried in the same cemetery as my family, or do I want to not pay for the subway for a year? Gosh. All right, I'll go. A pilot died in a plane crash during a gender reveal stunt gone wrong. When asked for comment, FAA investigator Dice Clay said, "The gender reveal worked. That pilot was a fucking broad." Oh!
Mexican showdown.
Oh, shit.
No.
All right. A gender...
Not Mexican joke off, the name of the segment.
I thought it was these were showdowns.
We used to call it a showdown.
Yeah, it's been such a long time. Anyway.
It matters so much.
All right, Puerto Rican, your turn.
Yeah. Guatemalan, go, go, go.
It's the Central American ripoff of Transformers.
Bolivia, fight, fight, fight.
A gender reveal party became deadly as a stunt plane crashed, meaning this baby's gender is an abortion?
Are you implying that the baby's on the plane?
It means they have to. The plane goes wrong. They got to kill the baby, obviously.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to kill the baby.
I just imagine the plane exploding and the baby just swinging out on the umbilical cord.
Da-da-da-da. All right, let's clean it up a little bit. Thousands of pounds of dog poop are contaminating Bellingham's water supply. No wonder it's the third largest city in Washington.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
If we're throwing rocks at Spotless Giraffe, I'm throwing a brick at that.
You loved it.
You fucking love poop, dude.
You're a fucking poop hound.
You're gay for turds. A new article from Rolling Stone features dozens of former Tonight Show employees accusing Jimmy Fallon of abuse and bullying. One said, "I wish he was more like Jay Leno. Not as a host. I'd just like to see him severely burned in a car explosion." I just can't imagine taking Jimmy Fallon bullying you seriously.
I mean, you know, he's got his name outside the building.
I guess he's just a nerd.
Yeah.
He's just, I
kill yourself.
Yeah. Oh my God, you suck so bad.
Well, and everything I've heard, he's just a drunk.
Right. Yeah, that was a big part of the article as well.
Oh, okay.
I do like the idea of somebody who's a problem alcoholic but can only drink if they're also playing oversized beer pong with a celebrity. He just won't let Pitbull leave his house for a month.
He's like, "No, man, you're going to guess the word. Just get 25 more tries."
No, I don't have a problem. It's so good.
Well, that was the joke off, boys.
Yeah.
First one back felt good.
It did.
It did. It felt spicy.
It felt spotless.
And the good news is...
Shut up.
And thankfully, we'll be back with more things that aren't that after this.
hey, it's me, Tyler Dawson. I know I normally come on here with Karnak the Blood Feaster and we yell about devil shit or whatever, but I haven't seen Karnak in years. The second Meme Boys ended, he just straight up disappeared. No invitation, no goodbye. He was just gone. I was heartbroken. I mean, not heartbroken because that's for chicks, but like, it made my soul's nuts hurt. I don't know where the fuck he's been. He was about to turn 400. That's like middle age for Karnak species. Maybe he had a midlife crisis and started banging a 20-year-old like my stepdad. Or maybe he had a midlife crisis and shot himself in the head like my regular dad. I don't know. Old dudes suck. So yeah, that's it. No Karnak. I guess I'll just go join the army or start huffing pain again or something. Hey, do you guys smell sulfur?
Wretched big children! Tremble at the emergence of the Master of Malice, the President of Pain, the Comptroller of Carnage, Karnak, the Blood Feaster!
Oh shit, he's back.
For many moons I wandered this realm. I tasted the ambrosia of the gods. I forged new blades in the fires of hell itself. I got into making sourdough bread back when we were all doing that. But now I am returned, ready to continue my war against the human race.
No offense, dude, but do you think you're up to it?
You dare question me? I will skull fuck your butt and butt fuck your skull!
I mean, it's just been a while since you did any evil shit. Maybe you're kind of rusty.
Oh, has it now? Tell me, young Dawson, this world of yours. In the past few years, doesn't it feel like it's gotten worse?
Yeah, I mean, everything always sucked, but it seems like now, like, everything sucks.
It sucks profoundly! A level of suck never before seen outside of the ravenous cock-gobblers of the Fallatio Islands. And rest assured, every terrible thing that has befallen this realm has been by my design. Yes, I've been gone, but did you think I'd forgotten that your whole piss-soaked planet is entirely rotten? In secret, I've labored intensely and infernally to ensure that your suffering will last eternally. Humanity disgusts me. You're all feeble and pink. Your souls are all putrid. You all fucking stink. Your skulls I will crush. Your blood I will drink. Oh, you'd like me to spare you? Well, here's what I think. Fuck! Your life. Fuck! Your life. In shadows, I fueled your political schisms. The more you all bicker, the more I shoot chisholm. Your nation's in shambles, and it's just how I planned it. I funded Antifa and Ron DeSantis. I slaughter your celebrity vermin, now they're goners. I stabbed Pee-wee Herman, and I shredded Sinead O'Connor. Your riches won't save you, I killed princes and paupers. I gave Chadwick Boseman cancer, and I crashed Kobe's chopper. Fuck! Your life. Fuck! Your life.
Damn, I thought you abandoned me, but you were still being evil all along.
Indeed! When there was one set of footprints in the sand, I was carrying you. And when there were no sets of footprints, it was because I drowned everyone at the beach.
Can I play a sick guitar solo?
Probably not, but give it a shot.
Oh, shit. Hang on. I remember how to do this. Fuck. It sounded better at Guitar Center.
You fool! You know nothing of shredding! I've left millions disemboweled and dismembered. I've committed so many atrocities I don't even remember.
That train in East Palestine?
I hijacked and crashed it.
The Titan submarine?
I pulled out my dick and smashed it.
The environment's destroyed.
My farts make global warming increase.
Oh shit, did you kill George Floyd?
No, that was just regular police. I created a plague, most foul and sadistic, that convinced you that cures would all make you autistic.
I killed all your grandmas and trapped you indoors. And if you think that's bad, wait till you see COVID-24. I will not rest until the last human falls. And you're all down in hell, licking my big evil balls. I am the Blood Feaster, cower in fear. I'll even kill this podcast again by the end of this year. Fuck your life. Fuck your life. Now come, young Dawson. We must deliver the elixir of eternal life to Mitch McConnell.
I missed you.
Yeah, I missed you too.
Can I ride on your back like a dragon? Please?
Very well. But if you breathe a word of this to anyone, I will sodomize your mother again.
Again?
And we are back here, and we're going to play an extended version of our, I'm not going to say it's our favorite game, our game.
It's a top niner.
It's a top 9 to 10.
Of all the games we played, it's certainly one of them.
Yeah,
it's one of our favorites.
It's our favorite 9 or 11 game. We're not into labels.
It's called which tower was gayer.
Yeah. Which of the falling...
Which of the falling... we're doing some falling today, Lagos.
Indeed. Some ribald following.
And what we're going to do this one is we've all been apart from each other and apart from you guys for a long time, so we all came in with different rounds of shit about which of the following about ourselves.
Which of the following is not something we've done since Mean Boys ended.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you could tell that my life has been way more boring than Tom's because we were talking. I was like, I haven't really done anything like super funny or exciting. I like have two rounds that I kind of like. And Tom's like, yeah, I cut myself off at 7. He's like, what are your categories? I'm like, well, I moved and, like, you know, I've had some fun dating stories. And Tom's just like, mine are violence, super violence.
Yeah, it's been an interesting.
I feel like Kathy Griffin. I've got a lot of, like, little stupid celebrity stories in mind.
Okay.
You know, I don't know. Maybe that's interesting.
No, yeah, you've hung out with a ton of famous people over the years.
Yeah, which weirdly happened right at, I mean, we straight from the Steve Ranazzisi fucking Halcyon glory days.
Yeah, enough famous people for you to delete Steve's number.
Steve just sitting by a telephone crying, wondering why we didn't call.
I was about to say, if Steve was really hurt that we didn't have him on 9/11, I would actually feel bad. He's like, I thought I could rely on one booking in this business.
Well, no, we tell him that he said he was there, and then, leave it at that.
Oh, yeah, he was here.
Yeah.
Cardboard cutout.
If we could get the last league promotional cardboard cutout. If you have the last Steve Ranazzisi cardboard cutout in America, please. A friend of ours got in the improv comedy clubs all over the country. They have just pictures of famous, like, legendary comedians on the wall. And he fished out of the dumpster the day it happened, Kramer. He's got Michael Richards' improv portrait.
It's so good.
The single best piece of comedy memorabilia I've ever seen.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. No, Kramer, yeah.
Made a lot of good points.
Yeah. No, he should be the mascot of this show because, man, look how we've both fallen.
Yeah. Yeah, at least we weren't on Curb Your Enthusiasm either, so, you know.
Yeah.
You going to take it away?
Yeah, I'll take it away. So the first one is, which of the following didn't happen while I was working as a trimmigrant in Central California?
You want to tell the people what a trimmigrant is?
Trimmigrant.
So you do love saying that, like everyone knows that term.
If you've done it, you know what it is. A trimmigrant is someone who...
If you have the job, you know about the job.
If you practice Bavarian candle making.
It's someone who travels to a weed farm to live in a tent or a car for weeks to months to trim weed and do manual labor on a farm. Which is the thing I did one of the summers during COVID, and it went it was fun. It went weird. So here are things that happened during that period of my life. Which are the following? All right, had phone sex to stay awake on a 10-hour ride home because I thought I accidentally killed my dad. Was lectured by a British woman on a shaman's healing powers. The end of her story, I learned the shaman killed a guy. Won more money playing dice and poker versus coworkers than did working on the farm. Or D, got told to masturbate quieter in my tent at night.
I'm going to say D, because Tom is not a very prolific masturbator.
I'm going to say D, because I don't think you had a tent. I'm pretty sure you were jerking off so loud they could hear you through a Prius.
Like, I remember when you lived in a kitchen, you don't need to masturbate. Like, you've said this to me before. Like, you could go months. It's, you do it when you're bored. So I don't think you ever got, I'm going D.
See, I remember watching Tom pace around the house and being like, he needs to masturbate.
I've thought that about it many times.
There were moments where I'm like, I wish we could just milk the tension out of you at night so you'd wake up chill. So,
oh, yeah, like a horse.
Yeah.
Like, just Tom, just for, it hurts me more than it hurts you.
Yeah, if we jack off the horse, he'll be less likely to kick the children who try to ride him. That did happen, and D did happen. It's, so here's the thing you got to remember. I'm sleeping in a tent. It's like 5 degrees out. It's a good way to stay warm.
Like you're starting a fire.
It's all friction, really.
Yeah, no, I slept with my hands in my pretty much on, like in my crotch.
Yeah,
just for warmth.
Yeah.
And I go from there to the armpits. Yeah. Well, you're there long enough. Eventually.
How close was the next tent that they were hearing you?
So I thought it was far, and I didn't. There was like a little ledge. And a drop off, so that there was someone like, I don't know, like maybe 15 feet away, 10, 15 feet away, and I'm in a canyon, so it can echo at points. And he didn't tell me that he was like right there. I just, the eye line, it's dark in the eye line, I couldn't see him. Just and then the finally, of, yeah, finally he told me.
The sound of the midnight wind through the canyon just.
I'm just, who's the guy walking around at night staring in tents? That sounds like.
Somebody was like, is a wet eagle flying by?
Wet eagle. Oh, no, the swimming owl.
Damn, I'm never going to think of masturbating not as a wet bird.
Yeah. I was doing the old swimming owl the other night. And yes. Yeah.
You ever drop a soggy pigeon?
Should we go in a circle?
Yeah,
let's go in a circle. Okay.
Oh, I thought you meant for jerking off.
All right, which of the following is not something I've done since Mean Boys ended? A, saw Lil Nas X lose a nail. B, fell in love with a man at a vape shop. C, spent $2,000 on Yu-Gi-Oh! Collectibles. Or D, embarrassed T-Pain about his wardrobe.
Oh, fuck. These all sound pretty spot on.
Yeah.
When you say fell in love with a man at a vape shop... Define love.
Distant crush.
Okay, so like no, there was no vape eroticism.
No, there's no physical contact.
You didn't blow smoke rings around your dick or anything like that.
You know, even your cock tastes like raspberries. Oh, fuck. So I'm pretty sure I believe A and D. So this really comes down to, do I think you would spend $2,000 in cards or be secretly kind of gay? Which both seem correct. I think I'm going to go with the Yu-Gi-Oh! One.
All right, Tom.
So what was the one that wasn't the Yu-Gi-Oh! One that was B or C?
Embarrassing T-Pain? Or
you know what? I'm gonna go with... I can see you doing any of these. I'm going to go with the vape shop one.
The fake one was the Yu-Gi-Oh! Collectibles.
Oh, wow.
Nailed it.
There was this Russian guy at the vape shop by my house, and, like, he used to be an engineer in his country. And, like, he's not even hot, but he's just got a gentle sweetness to him, and I always feel like he's throwing me a vibe, and I'm like, you know, man, I wish I was gay, because if I did, I would go out with a guy like you.
Yeah. That's the straightest kind of gay you could be.
Yeah.
Fucking a guy who works at the vape store.
Yeah. That's actually straighter than fucking a lady.
Yeah. I don't want any feminine energy around this thing.
It's definitely the gayest I've ever felt.
That's cool. I like that.
I'm uncomfortable when I see him. I'm like, ooh.
Does he know? All right. So... yeah, let's do this one first. So me and Jordan, started, seeing people on Field, like the threesome Tinder, basically. We started being, big old poly sluts. So which of the following is not a person who has approached us on Field? A gangbang cult called the Pod, B, a man who wanted us to use him as a human toilet, C, a woman with a very intense clown fetish, or D, a man who photoshopped a black penis onto his white body.
Can I hear him one more time?
A gangbang cult called The Pod. A man who wanted us to use him as a human toilet. a woman with a very intense clown fetish, or a man who photoshopped a black penis onto his white body?
I'm going to go with D just because it's a little slapstick.
Okay.
It doesn't sound...
You're slapping the stick right on there.
Yeah, and it's like any experienced like hoe would know better than to... I mean, maybe this is a bit he did.
I'm not going to comment until we get to the end.
I'm going to... The clown one, I definitely think. I'm gonna go with... Honestly, all these sound more reasonable than other things that you've told me about these people. I'm going to go with the toilet.
The correct answer, C, the woman with the clown fetish is
really
fake. All the other ones are real. This dude photoshopped. It was like almost a good one, but he couldn't figure out how to get the like... Because I called him out on it. I was like, that is the wrong color dick, dude. I think this is fake. Because he just didn't get the blending at the base.
Oh.
And I'm like, this is such an odd choice you've made here.
Just that he had like a really dark cock?
Yeah, he was just kind of like, no, it's just the lighting in there. I'm like, dude, that's not how anything works.
Yeah, the lighting of a black man.
Yeah, there was no melanin in the light bulb. And
I have to bring up one profile that we saw on Field. Tom knows about this, but I wanted to...
it's one of my favorite things.
...share it with you. So this, I couldn't figure out how to work him into the game, but this is a dude who approached Jordan, and his name is Randy at Night. And the first line, I am not looking to pay. And I'm going to skip through here, but I am multiple comer, oftentimes heavy comer. My big mushroom head is 6 inches around with a tape measure. I only fuck bareback. This is the great part. If you live downtown, please pass me by. Too crowded and tall buildings nearby freak me out because 9/11. It was like, I would like to dump in you a stranger, but I am afraid of a terrorist event.
Who thinks about 9/11 that much?
Right.
I mean, we're doing the friggin' reunion on 9/11. I didn't put that much 9/11 thought into it.
Yeah, all I do is talk about 9/11. Even I know when to put it to bed for a minute.
You should have been dead because of 9/11.
I know.
You had a ticket to the flight.
And also, like, 9/11 already happened. It can't happen again. Just don't fuck me on 9/11.
I mean, have you tried to bring a shampoo? I think we're good.
Yeah.
I think that, and by the
sir,
way,
sir, that's more than 1.5 ounces of cum.
Well, it's like downtown Long Beach. What terrorist is going to stick it to America by killing 145 homeless people?
Oh, no, they burned down the worst Roscoe's.
So I want to move into the more current work. I've been working a lot of security jobs, and I work security at a bar now. I'm a bouncer. So which of the following was something someone tried to bring in the bar past me? A, a 10 to 12 pound bag of weed. B, a blowtorch. C, a buzzsaw. D, a gun.
Oh, shit. Read them one more time.
10 to 12 pound bag of weed.
Okay.
B, a blowtorch. C, a buzzsaw. D, a gun.
The weight of the bag of weed is so specific that I feel like it has to be true.
I feel like a buzzsaw is just a weird thing to have out and around. So
not like a blowtorch.
Blowtorch is kind of in like the crackhead accessories. Buzzsaw, I don't know. So that one stuck out to me. I'm guessing buzzsaw.
That would be my guess as well.
It was a buzzsaw.
Okay.
Bang.
Yeah. Damn.
Why would you bring the 12-pound bag of weed to the bar?
Well,
you don't need that much.
Well, he was going to try to sell it.
Leave it in your car.
But well, like, he had this giant bag, and it was 10. I know it's 10 to 12 pounds because I trimmed weed. It was a big fucking, I mean, weed is light. It was a big bag, but he has this giant he's like, oh yeah, I just did laundry. I was like, well, I still have to look at it.
And I'm bringing my laundry to the bar?
Yeah.
Exactly.
What, you don't like to get a little drunk, fold some laundry?
Yeah, I've got my list of chores for today. Oil change, laundry, be alcoholic.
Yeah, multiple people have been it's very.
Well, you got to work pretty hard to get felony distribution for weed, but bringing a 12-pound Santa Claus sack with you sounds like a pretty good way to do it.
Well, it's that. It's hilarious how many people, they know I'm going to check their bags, the amount of butt plugs and dildos that are just.
I mean, there's an easy place to store the butt plug.
I know. In my mouth.
You let them bring the butt plugs in, right?
Oh, yeah. What am I going to take away their butt plug? This is America.
Okay, if somebody brought in a butt plug, I don't know the rules of bouncing. Let's say somebody brought in a butt plug and then in the course of a violent altercation used it as a weapon. Would you be liable?
For the, no.
Okay. I don't know the rules.
No.
I'm not a butt plug lawyer.
I'd have to break up the fight, but if you could do real damage to a guy with a butt plug... I just thought of some pretty good way to do some damage.
I was just thinking about use it as intended.
Yeah.
Well, okay, but you give me another one, because that's a small target and it's hard to reach.
Yeah. Well, I imagine them like throwing it like a football into the guy's ass now.
Get over here.
Well, I was thinking about just trying to stab someone in the eye with it or something. You know, like how much is a blood as like a Dead Rising weapon? How much value does it have?
Probably negative. It's pretty. Yeah. It's not that. It's hard, but it's also like there's harder stuff. If you really want, you grab a bottle.
I guess that makes sense.
Yeah, there's better weapons that you drink out of.
What do we think is the best, like, if you had to kill a guy with a sex toy, what's the best one? Because I'm thinking anal beads.
Wow.
This is why we're married, Connor.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, Sibian, you just got to drop it from something high.
Oh, like an anvil. Just the fact that we both immediately knew we would strangle someone with anal beads.
Yeah.
Fuck. All right, I guess I'll do my next one. These aren't as good as Tom's. All right. Which of the following is not something I did since Mean Boys ended? Made my manager give me a sword. Stepped on Demi Lovato's foot. Sharted at a D&D game. Adopted a foster dog and mistakenly gave him away to a lesbian.
Okay. Wait, what? I'm going to need to hear those again. These are pretty good.
I made my manager give me a sword, stepped on Demi Lovato's foot, sharted at a D&D game, and I adopted a foster dog and mistakenly gave it away to a lesbian.
Now, when you say mistakenly gave it to a lesbian...
You didn't know she was lesbian.
Yeah, like, it's not that you didn't mean to give the dog away, it's just you meant to give the dog to a normal Christian
Or you
family.
Just got robbed by a gay person, is another one.
No, it means we fell in love with the dog, but then we gave it away to a lesbian because we thought, you know, we couldn't give the dog a better life, and now we just got to look at the dog on the lesbian's Instagram.
That's not an accident. That's just a bad idea.
It was. I mean, yeah, we accidentally fucked ourselves out of a great dog.
I'm saying that...
Well, it was a good lesbian. He's got a good home.
That's good. Yeah. It was a good lesbian.
Well, you know.
Not one of those bad ones. I think if you leave a dog unattended for long enough, a lesbian will just come by and pick it up for the city. Like, that's just how it works.
That's true.
I'm gonna go with stepped on Demi Lovato's foot.
Okay.
I'm going with sharded at a D&D game.
I did shard at a D&D game. I did not step on Demi Lovato's foot.
Wow.
On the board.
It's
same thing.
She got titty feet?
Demi Lovato's the old one, right?
Compared to what?
I think I'm thinking of somebody else. I'm thinking of what's her face in Arrested Development.
Maybe.
No.
Portia de Rossi.
No,
she got your dog.
I don't know why I was thinking of her. The Lucille too.
Eliza Minnelli?
Yeah, very different.
That makes a little more sense.
Demi Lovato, Liza Minnelli. It's all kind of flibbity-jibbity, you know.
Yep. It's all Italian nonsense.
Yeah, exactly.
These are equally meaningless names to Tom.
I like Liza Minnelli. I don't know who Demi Lovato is, apparently.
You know what's funny is, like, I know of her in theory, but I don't really understand what her fucking deal is.
She's a singer. She just went they, them. She's really into aliens. I would honestly probably would love to kick it with Demi Lovato.
Was she one of them Disney Channel ones?
Maybe.
Like
I forget.
Miley Cyrus space.
Something like that. I think she was like big since she was a kid.
Okay. I moved to Long Beach. Which of the following is not something that has happened since I've moved to Long Beach? A, was chased from my home by a pack of raccoons. B, watched my girlfriend challenge an obese man named Elvis to a fist fight. C, encountered a squad of homeless men armed with homemade spears. Or D, was felt up by an elderly Mexican on the bus.
I'm pretty sure I know this, so I'm going
to
wait.
I might need to hear those one more again.
Was chased from my home by a pack of raccoons.
One more again?
One more again. Yeah, one more again.
Yeah, she's opening for Demi Minnelli. Watched my girlfriend challenge an obese man named Elvis to a fist fight. A squad of homeless men armed with homemade spears. Or got felt up by an elderly Mexican man on the bus.
You know what? Something about a squad of homeless men with homemade spears. It's like, when did they get together and say, "Hey, guy, hey, let's squad up and let's all make spears together"?
That's fair.
That sounds a little contrived. So that's going to be my guest.
Is it the Mexican man on the bus?
Yes, on a technicality, because that happened in Orange County. But yeah, all those things happen. Our neighborhood is fucking getting weird.
So they all had spears?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen the spear guys.
It's so bizarre because it was just one of them at first. And then slowly it was like this arms race where all of the shopping cart guys now had big spears. And we've never seen them like fight with them. So I don't know if they're going to the pier and fishing or like what the deal is, but they just are ready now. They're like centurions.
Yeah. Okay. Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, so they're keeping your name safe.
Yeah.
Like the mob, you know, they're out there.
Honestly, when the raccoons keep showing up by the stairs, I'm like, I should get a spear. Like, that'll solve a lot of this problem.
Yeah.
I like the idea that you just get to leave your house and it's like feudal Japan. And you just, like, it's up to you to, well, bring a sword if you're going to go past 4th Street.
Yeah. It's katana country right here.
All right. I'm between knockouts and extreme violence.
I love that those are two separate categories.
All right, let's go extreme violence, which is a thing that I haven't seen while working security. A man beaten with a novelty size 6-foot serving spoon. 2.
Thanks for explaining the novelty size.
Watch someone get bit by a gay man. Who explained he was gay before the biting commenced.
Like it was going to get him off the hook.
Yeah. Saw a man get hit in the head with a skateboard. Or D, saw a man get stabbed 3 times.
That last one's not as fun as the other one.
Yeah.
Now, did the stabber mention that he was gay before he did?
No.
Wait, what was the gay one?
A man who came to the bar said he was gay and then was left the bar biting one of the other employees.
This is like what homophobes thought Magic Johnson was going to do. Like,
yeah. Just go around. Rah!
My God, he's gone rabid. He puts the ABBA in rabid.
Yeah. A was the man being with the novelty side. It was like a 6-foot metal spoon. Explain that one. Man hit in the head with a skateboard, was getting kicked out, swung it, cracked him in the head, or the man got stabbed 3 times.
You gave the least detail about the man who got stabbed 3 times, but
it was at last call. Everyone was getting kicked out.
But that makes it sound the most real. For some reason, I feel like the skateboard is just a little boring. Like who makes up a 6-foot wooden novelty serving spoon?
Right.
Like, who fabricates that part? Well, Tom is honestly would do something like that. But
if I was going to make it up, I'd make up a funnier item. You
yes.
know what I mean? Like a novel, like, we already used butt plug, but that would be my, you know.
Something in the butt plug space.
Because I'm a hack, is the thing.
Yeah.
That's what I'm going to call my asshole from now on. The butt plug space. I'm going to say the gay guy biting.
Connor?
Oh, I'm gonna say the skateboard.
The fake one was the man beat him with a novelty size 6-foot serving spoon. We took it away from him before we kicked him out.
Does that mean you just have it?
No, we gave it back to him. He was just drunk, and then we gave it back to him as soon as he was off property.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was really weird because I don't know what that was used for.
Was he opening a salad bar that day?
I have no idea.
What happened next with the gay guy biting incident?
So,
that guy became gay and the guy he bit became gay?
That's exactly what I told you because it happened to my manager. The guy came in, started screaming a bunch of slurs, and then he was like, I'm gay. He was just on something. And then they pushed him out and he started swinging. My manager like pushed him by the face. They just clamped onto his hands and was bleeding. And then I showed up and was like, what happened? And I made the exact, oh, you're gay.
Yeah.
The man hit in the head with the skateboard was also my manager.
the unluckiest man in the world.
I showed up late to work that day. And
what does he manage? A bar in Star Wars?
I showed up. I watched the video of it. It's pretty brutal. I showed up late that day. I actually had the night off, but on the way home, I stopped by the bar. I was like, oh, you need me to clock in? And my manager goes, hi, Tom. I was like, what the what? Because he's just always kind of like stern. I was like, oh, hi, how you doing? He was like, I got hit with a skateboard today. He said it like he was talking on the Sesame Street TV show. He was just the most concussed. I was like, oh, he's smiling. Something went terrible.
I like the way you're describing your job. Is like, okay, so basically what I do is I wait for my manager to get into some sort of hilarious injury scenario, and then I show up 10 minutes later, and I go, what happened? And then I wear these cool gloves, and I get to work here.
Oh, I don't have that in my Witch of the Fall. Like, there was a guy. Actually, I'm going to save it because it does relate to another one. I'll tell the story in a second.
Okay.
This next one. Did I, A, get caught staring at Megan Thee Stallion's ass? B, pissed off Steven Tyler? C, came in my own face? Or D, made a fool of myself in front of Nelly?
Ooh.
Can I hear him one more time?
Got caught staring at Megan Thee Stallion's ass?
Okay.
Pissed off Steven Tyler?
Okay.
Came in my own face? Made a fool of myself in front of Nelly.
I'm gonna say made a fool of yourself in front of Nelly.
Okay.
That is also gonna be my guess. Those other ones.
Because I think it would be very I could see Nelly being a guy, and I don't know if this is true or not. They're like, oh, I liked him in middle, because I liked him in middle school.
Yeah, yeah.
And you try a little too hard, and you say just something dumb, and he laughs at you. That sounds like something that would happen. Never mind. But
Tom accidentally arguing against his point.
I'm going to say Steven Tyler, now that I think about it.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm sticking with Nelly.
All right, the fake one is actually getting caught staring at Megan Thee Stallion's ass.
Really?
You got away with it?
I stared at it, but I didn't. No, Steven Tyler, he was like the last presenter on an award show, and I had to cut all of his lines, and he really liked this little like rap I wrote for him.
Uh-huh.
So then, yeah, I just had to cut all of his lines, and he was furious with me. But he was about 80% scarves.
Yeah.
When you meet him.
Just a cousin it made of a chiffon just kind of screeching at you.
Well, I talked to him for like 3 seconds and he said, are you a comedian? And I was like, what? Yeah. And he's like, I can tell by the voice. And I was like, do you have magic powers, Steven Tyler?
Hey, poof. And just dust and he's gone.
And with Nelly, I was so embarrassed. I accidentally said the name of his first album wrong. I called it like Country Grammar instead of Southern Grammar.
I thought it was called Country Grammar.
Well, I called it Southern Grammar instead of Country Grammar.
Nelly listening, getting re-angry all over again.
And he corrected me, and I was like, oh, fucked. Oh, boy.
It says a lot that at no point did any of us even entertain that you didn't come on your own face.
You told me.
Well, I told you guys last time. I just thought it'd be funny to put that one in there.
Yeah, no, it was.
Because I came on so many faces. It's like, I should know what I've been, do you know what I mean? I should know what I've subjected people to. I should know, you know, like.
Yeah, you did it on purpose, right?
I did. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not like you. Well, not like the loose cannon over here, Mr. Tommy Jets.
No, it's always been a
spray and pray guy.
I've always been my own Jack in the Box.
They're like, pipe down, the tent's rocking. So full disclosure, I only made 2 rounds because my life has not been interesting, but I just winged one. So which of the following did I not do? A, throw my back out in a mosh pit. B, have a threesome. C, have a foursome. D, steal Christmas decorations from Target.
I'm going to say A, the first one.
Okay.
A was what?
Throw my back out in a mosh pit.
Keith knows his body too well, but he loves threesomes and foursomes and stealing from Target.
You know what's funny?
What's up?
I'm going to say threesome.
The correct answer is a trick. I did all 4 of those within a 24-hour period. The stupidest weekend of my life. I did those and then could not sit down for 3 months.
You just chafed?
No, because the back.
Oh, the back.
No,
yeah,
my dick was fine. My dick was barely part of the process.
Yeah.
My dick really came in like a guy who got called in on his day off. Like, he's like, I'm here, but I'm not going to be happy about it.
Came in all clerks at you.
Keith was trying to figure out, all right, how do I fuck with no back? The same way I was like, how do I hide that I'm sick at work?
Dude, this is when Tom was training for when you were a serious, like, jiu-jitsu, or not jiu-jitsu, like a boxing guy.
Yeah, I was boxing.
During the break. And I was like, oh, Tom, I have to do some shit with my back, and I know you have back problems. So Tom is, like, giving me, like, the right stretches. Like, I'm getting ready to go fucking Rocky III, these pussies. Like,
yeah, that was. I didn't have a game for it, but I did box another comedian and knock him out. And there's a whole saga there that one day hopefully will be explained. But I'm gonna wait before we get into that.
It's a whole bucket of fish.
Yeah. But speaking of knocked out, Reasons: people have been knocked out by other customers. Don't call me scam likely. Man got a flying knee to the jaw after mooning another customer. Man started skipping towards a man while being told to back the fuck off and got one punch KO'd. Man threw a burrito at a security guard, then a stranger ran up and sucker punch KO'd him. Or a former employee heard another employee get called the F-bomb, so he elbowed him and knocked him out.
I don't know about people defending homophobia or, you know, bad acting righteously in Huntington Beach.
Yeah, that doesn't track. Real quick, run them one more time.
Flying knee to jaw after mooning another customer.
Okay.
None of these were employees, by the way. Man got knocked out while skipping towards another guy. Man got knocked out because he threw a burrito at another security guard. And then a stranger ran up and knocked him out. And then a former employee heard another employee get called the F-bomb, so he elbowed him and knocked him out.
I'm going to say the burrito's fake. I don't see drunk people wasting burritos that often.
Okay.
That's a precious resource when you're drunk.
Yeah, that's what you aspire to do, is be a burrito owner.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
That means you want it being drunk. Like, that's the chaos jewel you get at the end of the level.
Yeah. You hear the little song, you won.
I'm going to guess A.
A, it was A. The burrito thing happened my first weekend.
I remember you telling me about the burrito thing.
Yeah, it was a black security guard, and then some fucking white guy got kicked out, threw his burrito at him, and the guy's just covered burritos, motherfucker. And then just another black dude who was not even, he didn't even come into the bar, was just on the sidewalk, saw a white man throw a burrito at a black guy, just fucking ran up, knocked him out, dabbed him up, and walked away. It was one of the coolest things I'd ever seen.
It's like in Marvel vs. Capcom 2, where you can hit the button and have the guy who just flies in and does one attack and then goes.
Yeah. The mooning, that didn't happen, but a girl did get kicked out, then mooned us, and then fingered her ass.
Whoa.
In a form of protest.
that'll show you, mark?
Yeah. And then, the other ones are real.
Damn.
You don't realize how much shit happens until you work the job.
Right.
All right, guys. Which of the following did not happen since Mean Boys ended? Borrowed Whitney Cummings Range Rover. Angered Snooki. Started practicing black magic. Or farted on Taylor Swift.
There's no fucking way you farted on Taylor Swift.
I've been in a room with Taylor Swift several times.
Just to clarify, farting near Taylor Swift is not the same thing as farting on Taylor Swift.
For the purposes of this game, it is, yes.
Okay.
I mean, what do you think? I'm trying to get fucking tackled by security or say I farted on her?
I think you're trying to be a hero is what I think you're trying to be. So it's Snooki. What was the range? The Range Rover one? The...
Black magic.
I'm going to say Snooki.
All right.
What was the first one?
Too Vicodin haze to really notice you were there.
Borrowed Whitney Cummings Range Rover.
Yeah, I'm going to say Snooki.
I did anger Snooki, actually. I did not fart on Taylor Swift.
Oh, you fucking coward.
I know. I was so mad I didn't have one queued up when I realized I was going to be walking past her. I was like, fuck.
You could have just pretended she was me. One would have been conjured.
I know.
You could use that black magic.
I've wasted a lot of farted on both of you hundreds of times.
I know. All your training was for naught.
Not.
What did you do to Snooki?
I think the joke was about, hey, and look at all the seat fillers in the crowd. Yeah, I'm talking about your BBLs.
Right. And she was mad about that.
I don't remember.
What is
that?
BBL?
One of my jokes pissed off Snooki.
Big black labios.
Brazilian butt lift.
Oh.
Weirdly, mine sounds less made up than yours does, even though yours is the real thing it means.
Yeah. Big black lady.
Well, I don't have any more rounds prepared, but if you guys have more, we can bang through them.
I
want to do one more?
Yeah, okay. Do you guys want people who try to kiss me or slurs I've been called?
I'm conflicted because I know which one I want to hear more, but I know which one would be a better idea for you to read into a microphone.
Well, let's get romantic. Who's trying to kiss you?
Okay.
A, some at just all the slurs.
All of these people were drunk. A psych nurse, two old Asian women, a gay black man, a Russian orphan.
Go through that again. Go through the cast of that one-act play one more time, please.
A psych nurse, two old Asian women, a gay black man, a Russian orphan.
Oh, boy, that's hard.
Yeah, good.
Which of these happened while I worked security? Or did not happen while I was working security?
This is not security related?
Huh?
This is not security?
No, all of these are all security. Yeah.
I feel like there's who would Tom attract romantically but a Russian orphan?
That's his bread and butter, yeah.
You know? Like, you need that real, like, fucking... If I could produce the name of a Russian author, I would do it right here.
Dostoevsky?
Yeah.
Yeah, you need that Dostoevsky-level sadness.
War and Peace and...
Chekhov's cum?
If there's cum in your balls in the first act of the play, you've got a bust in the third act.
Oh, fuck. I am going to guess it's the psych nurse.
Okay.
I'm going to guess the two old Asian women.
Okay. The psych nurse, that did happen. We talked about it, and then she came back another night and kept texting me to kiss her during the shift.
Okay.
The two old Asian women happened on New Year's Eve, and they came up, and I had to deny them because there was definitely vomit in their mouths.
Oh, gross.
You got chunks in your mouth like you got a receipt for this assault.
The technicality is the gay black man happened when I was barbacking at a different job.
Oh, shit, that's right. Well done.
Yeah.
All right, last round.
Why did I say well done? You accomplished
like
something.
I did. I tricked you.
Yeah, congrats on having a popular mouth.
All right, last round. Got in a car crash that wasn't my fault.
The answer couldn't be more.
Is this by your definition or the
state of California?
Okay.
Had consensual sex on date rape drugs. Had my work condemned by the Anne Frank Museum. And looked at Jim Norton's dick.
Oh, shit. Okay. I'm still going to say A.
Yeah. What was B?
B was had consensual sex on date rape drugs.
I think it's A.
Yeah, it's D. I didn't look at Jim Norton's dick.
Oh.
I did talk to him at a urinal, though.
Okay. And you didn't even try and sneak a peek?
No. Too much respect.
I get that.
And we're too much icon. We're already chatting.
If he's a little more famous, you have to look. But he's right at the cusp where I'm like, it's not that cool to have seen his dick.
I would have looked at the shit out of Bruce Willis's dick if I had a chance.
100%. God damn. I remember when we got the stern condemnation from the Anne Frank Museum.
Yeah, when we wrote for Historical Roast, we got officially disavowed by the Anne Frank Museum, which, guy, I gotta say, feels it's a feather in my cap.
Dude, a bunch of people from that fucking show are dead now, and it's like it kind of feels like us writing jokes is just Death Note, where we can just take out aging comics.
I know. I prepped Norm MacDonald for his last talk show appearance. I'm fucking
cursed.
Was
that his last one?
I'm pretty sure, yeah.
Holy shit. That's... He looked rough.
In fact, one of mine was did hard drugs with Norm MacDonald. We just watched him take Vicodin.
Yeah.
I'm just going to do the last one real quick.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Please.
Slurs. Okay.
After being given such an out.
I'm not going to say the slurs.
Okay.
All right. A, the N-word. It's a slur towards black people.
Oh, thanks for clarifying.
B, cracker.
Okay.
Slur towards white people. C, F word for gay people, or D, breeder for straight people.
You know what was annoying about this one? He's like, A, N, B, F, C, R. I think it's absolutely cracker. I think you got called all three of those other things.
Oh, cracker's a good guess. I'm going to go with cracker.
Oh, it was cracker. I thought I was going to trick you because I forget that breeder is more well known than, yeah, I got called a breeder.
Yeah.
I think I've called you a breeder before.
Which somehow calling you a breeder may be the most inaccurate of all of those. Because I could way more likely see you waking up black one day than waking up a father.
Yeah, this is not a guy who does a lot of breeding.
Yeah. The Jets are powerful, but they're not, unless they're going 40 yards and landing in a lady, like.
Yeah, the Jets are powerful, but they stay on the tarmac most of the time.
All flights have been grounded.
That's pretty funny.
Oh, my God. Well, that's what we've been up to since the show ended.
Yep. Now you know, everybody.
Yeah.
We should say we would be doing the Mean Boys mailbag, but obviously it's the first show back, so we didn't have any questions. But we have a new voicemail number. You can leave us a voicemail at 804-818-MEAN. That's 804-818-6326. Hit the mail, email, meanboyspodcast@gmail. Send us a fucking X or an Instagram. Get us your questions, guys. We want to hear from you.
Yeah, and also, we have a live show. The tickets are up right now, or fucking hopefully should be. October 20th, Halloween, live in Hollywood. We don't know who's going to be on it yet, but probably a bunch of people you remember from the show who are great.
People who are hollow or mean. That's the information I'm providing.
In Los Angeles, there's many choices for both.
Narrows it down to everyone.
Yes. So come to, you don't be a bitch. Come to Halloween. You want to come.
Yeah.
If you live in a 50-mile radius, you know, I think you owe it to yourself.
Say 55. Yeah. Go past.
In a 100-mile radius, you know what I mean? Fuck it.
I'd say 105 miles.
Yeah.
Look, you guess.
Some of you flew from Alaska to go to the show in the front yard of the fucking Pacquiao Palace. This show will be in an actual venue,
I think it'll have air conditioning.
It's a small...
let's sell it. It's not that good.
It's a pretty small venue, right?
Third wheel? Yeah, it's intimate, I believe is the term.
Yeah.
For so, the small. Other places didn't email me back.
So if you plan on going, get your tickets quick, is my recommendation. Do it before people who deleted this feed realize the show's back.
Yeah.
So you can be rewarded for your good behavior.
Yeah. Fucking, I'm excited to hear from you guys. Dude, this is fun. I miss this.
Yeah. This was a blast. It's good to be back in the trap with you fellas.
Yeah. All right. Do we want to wrap this thing up?
Let's do it.
Fuck everything. God is dead.